I have a simple question. Do you have any faith left in the CDC? Really? Because they've changed their views on things. They've done a poor job of communicating for more than a year, I think, and especially within the last couple of weeks. They've been all over the place, and I thought they were all over the place this weekend trying to explain themselves. Do we have any faith left in the CDC? You can call 410-467-WBAL. Give us a text on the Metro Bath the Tile text line, 410-467-9225. The big news, obviously, Tori, is that they came out last week and said, you don't have to wear a mask anymore. And everybody was like, what? You don't have to wear a mask? The CDC is saying this? The same CDC that was just getting in fights with United States senators about kids wearing masks and about camp counselors wearing masks outside are now saying that you don't have to wear a mask inside or outside? What are we talking about? The same CDC that has been so cautious about vaccinations and telling grandparents, well, I don't really know if you should go visit your grandkids or not. I wouldn't go out and eat at a restaurant, Dr. Fauci, and the whole nine yards. Now saying you don't have to wear your mask. And they did this in just kind of an announcement and no real press conference or any deep dive into exactly what it was they were talking about and why they came to this conclusion. And they tried to explain it this weekend. And you had Dr. Walensky out from the CDC this weekend saying about this. Dr. Fauci was obviously out, and I know he's not a member of the CDC, but, you know, he is our top COVID guy. There's no doubt about that in this country. And his point was, well, we now have new data showing that these vaccines are really effective. I think we've had this data for quite some time on this issue. But he said something else that really got me kind of just angry is not the right word, but just shaking my head like, what are these guys doing? What are they doing? John Dickerson of Face the Nation, who was on our show on Friday, asked Dr. Fauci, you know, has it been confusing? I mean, should you have been able to handle this better? And, you know, a lot of people are not really sure about what they can and can't do when it comes to masks, and they're uneasy about it. And he said, yeah, maybe we can do things, you know, but we just looked at the data. The data now shows that, without a doubt, we feel that people who are vaccinated shouldn't have to wear a mask outside and inside. He says, what we will be doing now is coming out very quickly with individual types of guidances. So people will say, what about the workplace? What about this? What about that? And I think that's going to be clarified. I think it's going to be clarified. I would imagine within a period of just a couple of weeks, you're going to start to see significant clarification of some of the actual understandable and reasonable questions that people are asking. Well, why do we have to wait for that? I mean, why isn't that right away? How does that not come out in just one giant, you know, casserole instead of, you know, this piecemeal stuff that they've been doing? And I think, honestly, that the CDC has just kind of ruined its reputation by the way they've handled the messaging when it comes to COVID, especially within the last couple of months.
Brian, the CDC has become the political propaganda wing of whoever's in power at the time. And this was the argument that was made when former President Trump was in office. It's certainly clear that the CDC is a convenient political tool of the Biden administration. Many people pointing out that this surprise guidance came at a time when the administration was having one of its worst weeks in the entire administration. You got the crisis, the gas lines, the horrible unemployment numbers. The administration is using the CDC as a political wing. And in my opinion, the whole fact that the CDC is not operating from a position of science expertise and professional conduct, it means that we should pretty much discard anything that they come out with, right? They can add all the recommendations that they want. I am listening to what the science says. And unfortunately, there's only a few scientists that are heeding the science. Here in Maryland, we have Dr. McCary, who I follow on Twitter. And I think he presents a lot of good scientific-based information. I'm following that guidance, and I'm really hoping that many of our institutions do the same.
Got a couple of texts, 410-467-9225. Brian, you finally hear what you want from the CDC, and you're still complaining. Come on. That comes from Mike. Okay, I think that's a little bit somewhat fair, Mike, but hear me out on this. And that is that they still are changing. And I got a feeling because they're getting so much pushback and that they never really clarified exactly why you should be able to do these things, that my sense of it is that the pushback, especially coming from the left and from Democrats, maybe even people within the administration that were caught off guard by the guidance that was put out by the CDC, I got a feeling they're going to change it back. That's why I say these things. Like, I'm expecting this week for them to have this new guidance that Fauci talks about, where they're going to say, well, you know, upon reflection, we believe that, you know, there's no way of knowing that somebody could wear a mask. We still want you to all wear a mask while you're inside until we get to a certain level. That's what I'm worried about. And that's why I say these things, because who knows? They've changed their mind so many different times on this, or they've come up with, you know, different messaging on it, that it may change again.
Bryan, the texter is making your point, right? You are hearing what you want to hear. I don't want to hear what I want to hear. I want to hear the truth, right? If they say something that I don't want to hear, but they back it up with science, then that's what I want to hear. We are hearing what the administration wants us to hear. And that's, I mean, when the texter sent that message, that was exactly the point that a lot of people are making. The CDC is simply pushing whatever convenient narrative is appropriate for them at the time. There is no science that's supporting what they're doing. They're not explaining their move, which is exactly why when they announced this guidance, people weren't upset that the guidance was changing. People were excited about it. The question everyone was asking is, why? Why now? What has changed? What are you using to measure this so that I can know that you won't be turning again to reverse your decisions? Well, you know, we didn't have enough information. There's no excuse for any of this guesswork. It has been a year since this pandemic started. These are professionals that are making hundreds of thousands of dollars to make these decisions. And the only thing that they're doing is saying what they think people want to hear. We're not paying for, you know, propagandites. We're paying for people to do science and to help keep our community healthy.
We got a text. What little faith I had in CDC and Dr. Fauci is now gone. They have sold their souls to the Democratic Party. That from Linda in Cockeysville. Another one says, please keep in mind the CDC is offering guidelines. Each state has autonomy. True. And some states have, this is why I've made the case with C4, that the CDC wasn't the one that was leading this. It was the state of Florida and the state of Texas, especially when Texas dropped its mask mandate and everybody went nuts. And the CDC said that this is the way to go. President Biden said it was Neanderthal thinking. And then a couple of weeks later, maybe a month later, a lot of Democratic lawmakers said, you know what? I think I would rather go with Texas and Florida than with the CDC at this point. I think they got it right. And once that started to happen, I think they just lost complete control of whatever the message was going to be. How can you in 1 week say that kids should have to wear masks outside and camp counselors should have to wear masks even if they're vaccinated outside around kids, and then say, if you're vaccinated, you don't have to wear a mask? How can you say that? In 1 week's time. And then, again, yesterday we heard from Dr. Fauci. I did think he had said something important, which he says that the data is showing that the vaccines are more effective than they thought, although there are a lot of people who have been saying that for quite some time. And he also says that even if you get a breakthrough infection, it is still very, very unlikely that you would be able to transmit it to someone else. So those are important markers. But at the same time, we don't have all the details about the workplace. We don't have the details about the schools, right? And these are things that people want to know. And every time you get out of your car or you go to someplace, you're like, do I have to have a mask on or do I not have to have a mask on?
The hard part about this, Bryan, is that you and I, right, the individual level of individuals, I think we're just ready to be done with it all. And we'd rather just make whatever decision we're most comfortable with. The problem is that employers don't have that luxury. Governments don't necessarily have that luxury because there's also liability. And I think that's really what people are concerned about is I think that part of the stimulus package and the negotiations, President Trump wanted to make it so that people couldn't be sued for, you know, getting COVID because of some guidelines. If the CDC guidance says one thing, the employer has an obligation to make a decision based on what the CDC is saying. So you and I can feel however we want. Our employers are going to be held accountable based on the guidance that's presented to them, which is why this is such a frustrating discussion. And honestly, there's no way to hold these guys accountable. As on the individual level, we can just ignore them, but a business can't do that. A school can't necessarily do that because they'll come back to, well, what did the CDC say?
Yeah, right. And what do they say today? And what are they going to say tomorrow? So yeah. It says Center for Disease Confusion. I think.
Yeah.
I think that's fair. I said can't discern crap because that's the way it's been for quite some time. I mean, honestly, if you have someone who has said that there is going to be impending doom, felt impending doom, and a month later says, "Oh, it's all clear. We don't have to wear masks anymore." If you get it that wrong, you have to question whether or not you're right for the job.
The science is never exact.
Yeah.
It's never exact.
No, I understand that. But if you're that wrong in a month's time, it should at least be talked about how completely wrong you were about it. And
so what's the recourse?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm not suggesting that Rochelle Walensky should be fired, but I do know this. If a military general got it that wrong in a month, I think there are a lot of people would be saying, I'm not sure if he's right for this mission.
Yeah, but the Biden administration, this is a very convenient tool for them. I mean, they ran their campaign off of this, right? So this is not anything that they're going to hold accountability. I am saying that I think that people just need to just ignore the CDC and do what they bet. I mean, Florida, did you hear that Governor DeSantis is literally pardoning anyone of any crime related to COVID violations, if they are facing any charges or anything? He's just pardoning them. Mm-hmm. I think we need to just ignore what the CDC is saying. And really, there's a huge body of evidence. I could even see some lawmakers, they won't get the support of the Democrats, but I could see a movement in which people say, we have no confidence in these national level health officials. We're going to make the best decisions based off the information that we have. That's what needs to happen.
Yeah. Well, look, everybody who listens to the show knows that I'm a pro-vax guy. I wanted the vaccine before it was available, right? I would have been more than happy to get involved in the trials. Give me the shot. I am pro-vax. Get your shot. The more people get the shot, the better it is. The thing is that you have so many people pushing, especially from the left, about this change from the CDC because the masks, we got to wear masks.
Yeah.
The tweet of the weekend, maybe the tweet of COVID, came from Mary Catherine Hamm, who said, maybe if we called the vaccine a mask, we could get people thinking it's powerful enough to protect them in a grocery store. That is ingenious. I mean, that is true.
Modern problems, modern solutions.
I mean, this mask. The vaccine is 1,000 times more effective than a mask, right? So if you've had the vaccine, it's like you're wearing 100 masks. So just get the shot, and then you don't have to worry about it. But, you know, we are so – it's the virtue signaling with the mask and what it means. I mean, we could do studies about that for years to come, about, you know, people who want to wear a mask and, you know, who felt like if you didn't wear a mask, you were not part of – the group effort to save America or to save the world. And they still feel like if you don't wear a mask, then you're not a part of that. When you know that the vaccination, me being vaccinated, is so much more important than someone wearing a mask, even if that person has been vaccinated. I mean, what are we talking about? It's
the problem is they can't prove that you've been vaccinated, and that's exactly where this is headed. They want to be able to say you have to be able to show a vaccine passport in order to do certain things. I'm calling it now. Give it a week or so. They're already talking about it. There's a debate in the White House about what you should do about vaccine validation. That's the end game.
Yeah, it's going to be hard to prove, and people are going to carry a card around that can be easily forged. If you want to protect yourself, get the vaccine, and then you are protected, right? Yep. I mean, that's just the bottom line on how to deal with it, and then you don't have to worry about everybody else. And I do think, well, I said this last week, I think one of the best parts about the CDC guidelines about not having to wear a mask is it will force those who are on the fence to say, you know what, people aren't going to be wearing masks anymore. Maybe I should go get the shot, and they'll be more likely to get the shot now than they were before the mandate went in place.
And that's a good point.
Stay tuned, because who knows, the policies may change. The guidelines may still change.